It's just tipped the scorecards, as you said.
Hey, let's take a look at it.
Once again, Micky Ward sets up that good body punch from going to the head first. He doesn't just throw it. He throws that shot up top to get the arm to lift a little bit, and then he goes down. Technique, science, not just brute force. Watch once again. Micky Ward will use that left hook to the head real quick, and then bang, down to the body. The headshot sets it up.
Kenny, through 9 rounds, Ward has thrown 1,007 punches. Burton has thrown 789. Burton, though, has landed 90 more punches, 358 to 268. The difference, though, that ninth round knockdown with that left hand to the body. Burton shoots a right over the top. Burton has scored 2 10th round stoppages in his career. In his last fight, he stopped Mike Griffith in the 10th.
Micky has Burton really watching now on those ropes, but Burton knows it. Burton wants to stay off those ropes and switch places with it. Smart move by Burton.
86-85 for Ward. I have an 86-84 for Ward.
Better round for Burton. Guess why, partner? Offense, not just defense. Burton is mixing punches in between those moves. Not like the last round where he went defensive a little too long. And Ward made him pay a price. See, Ward can't sit in there now.
Burton is tattooing Ward in this 10th round. Right hand to the chin.
Well, it's not quite close enough. See, there's a little space. And with that little bit of space, Burton is able to get his punches off. Mickey's the kind of fighter in this fight has to be all the way in or all the way out. When there's a little space, look for Burton to score.
Top from Ward.
If you've never been to a fight before, if you've never seen what fighters look like, you're seeing it. Real fighters, a real fight. Nobody has to tell these two men how to act.
Just what boxing needed after that tense in the Camacho fight last week.
All you promoters out there, I know you don't always have the best hearts in the world. Take all your money, give it to these two guys. Give it to them.
What a slugfest. Burton has had a very good 10th round here, Teddy.
Because he's moving his hands. He's not just going defensive.
Micky Ward threw 175 punches in that round. Burton tattooed him in that round. Somebody give these guys a big payday. They've earned it.
Start with a bonus tonight, and you promoters out there, for once, do the right thing. Give them a payday.
I added 5 rounds apiece. The knockdown in the 9th tips it in Ward's favor. How do the judges have it scored? What a war! Ward and Burton, the decision after this. Let's take a look at some of the final punch numbers. Ward threw 175 punches in the last round. You see that Burton was much more accurate in this fight. Power punches, Burton landed 386, Ward 314. Punches landed by round. Remember, in round number 9, a left hand to the body put Burton down to a knee. A knockdown in round 9 could be the difference in the judges' scorecards. Teddy Atlas's scorecard. 95-95. I had it 95-94 for Ward with the knockdown. I did not have that one even round. Judges' cards. Here's Mark Biro.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a unanimous decision. Judge John Stevens scores it 96-94. Judge Jim Finnegan sees it 96-91. And Judge Mike Nolan has it 98-90. All to the winner by unanimous decision, Irish Micky Ward.
Great fight. Ward, make the case, deserve to win the fight. But there were two blind mice judging it, Teddy.
I'm proud of these two fighters. I'm not proud of big scores right there. 1 point fight. Yes. Either way, a draw, 1 point either way. But
98-90?
Nine. The design of that fight with those kind of scores.
We will talk with Micky Ward. What a slugfest with Emanuel Burton, who came into Ward's backyard and gave it his all.